Hello everyone, welcome to Audit Course Lab 15B. Today we are going to discuss the analysis of the self-bias JFET circuit in LTSpice. So let us start with the analysis. So this is my self-bias circuit using N-channel JFET. My RG value is around 1 megohm. My RS value is 1.2 kilohms. RD value is 3 kilohm. And the supply voltage to power up the JFET is around 18 volts. Now we can label the terminals as JFET terminals as gate, drain, and source as capital G, capital D, and capital S. Okay, the given parameter is IDSS is given as 10 milliampere, and VP, that is the pinch of voltage, is given as around minus 4 volts. ID and IS are the terminal currents which we need to find, and VG, VD, and VS are the node voltages. Okay, so let us start analyzing the problem analytically and then we'll see it in the graphical form. Now let me just expand it a little. Yeah. So now from the circuit we can write VG is given by IG into RG, but VG is approximately equal to 0 since IG is 0 because of reverse bias gate source junction in a JFET. Okay, so if IG is 0, my VG will be approximately equal to 0. Okay, now VS is given by, next statement is VS is given by ID into RS, and actually initially it will be IS into RS, but ID is equal to IS. That's why we can write VS is equal to ID into RS. So we can write VS is equal to ID into 1200, and VGS is given by VG minus VS. So VG is 0, so VGS will be equal to minus ID into 1200. That is our equation number 1. Now the drain current in a JFET is also given by the formula ID is equal to IDSS into 1 minus VGS upon VP the whole square. Now here the IDSS and VP value are given. So we'll substitute over here. So IDSS is 10 into 10 raised to minus 3 into 1 plus VGS upon 4 because VP is minus 4 the whole square. So that is equation number 2. So from 1 and 2 we can solve. And we substitute the value of 2 in 1, we get VGS is equal to minus 1200. ID value we substitute from equation number 2. So this will be 10 into 10 raised to minus 3 in a bracket. 1 plus VGS upon 4 the whole square. So we'll open it, expand it, that is A plus B the whole square. So that will be 1 plus twice VGS upon 4, that will be VGS upon 2, plus VGS square upon 16. So we expand it further, we will get VGS is equal to minus 12 into 1 plus 0.5 VGS plus 0.06225 VGS square. And we'll open up the bracket over here and we'll arrange it in the form, we'll get 0.75 VGS square plus 7 VGS plus 12 equal to 0. So don't just write this down, you have to verify it in with your own calculator. So next we solve it quadratically. In a calculator we get two values of VGS. One will be minus, one will be minus 2.2629 volts and other one will be minus 7.07. We reject the value of minus 7.07 because VGS is less than VP in this case. Okay, so we accept the value of VGS is equal to minus 2.2629. And once we get the value of VGS, we can calculate the value of ID as follows. So ID will be given by the same formula. IDSS into 1 minus VGS upon VP the whole square. So ID will be given by 1.8859 milliamperes. Okay, so our first Q point will be VGS Q, ID Q, which will be minus 2.2629 volts, 1.8859 milliamperes. Now, once we get the value of IDQ and VGSQ, we can easily apply the KVL in the output loop. So KVL in the output loop will give us here. So VDD minus IDRD minus VGS minus VDS minus ID into RS is equal to 0. So if we apply the KVL in the drain source loop, we'll get finally this form. So VDS will be equal to VDD minus IDQ into RD plus RS. We substitute the value of VDD and IDQ and ID RD and RS. And if you work out in a calculator, we'll get a value as 10.07 volts. Okay. Now we can simulate these values in LTSpice and we'll get these results. Now we will do that shortly. Okay, so we'll open up the LTSpice and start building up the circuit. Okay, just a sec. Okay, so we have opened up the LTSpice. Now we'll start building up the circuit. So first we'll go to library. And for JFET, you type NJF. So this is your N-channel JFET. As you can see, paste it onto your screen. Okay, next will be your registers. So your registers, you can add it over here. We'll just zoom out a little. Yeah. Now we can add the registers. Leave some space because we have to label also. So here also we'll add one more register. And here also we'll add one more register over here. Like this. I guess here also. So these are the three registers. Now we'll join them together with a wire. So here it is. So make sure that all the connections are made with the help of this wire. So it is a self-bias JFET circuit, basically. Okay. Okay, so I'll connect the ground over here and ground over here. And you have to also select the power supply. So for power supply, I'll type just voltage and add it over here like this. And I'll connect it directly to the power supply. And power supply, the other terminal will go to the ground. Like this. Okay. So more or less our circuit is complete. Now we have to rename it. So we have to rename this as RD. The value is RD and the value is around 3 kilo ohm. Here the supply is VDD. Its value is given as 18 volts. And this is my RS. Its value is 1.2 kilo ohm. So write it over here. 1.2 kilo ohm. And this is RG, whose value is 1 mega. So how to, okay. So we have to write 1 mega. So you write it as 1 capital MEG, no space. Okay, so 1 mega, if you write 1 M, it won't work. So see to it that you write 1 capital MEG for 1 mega ohm. Okay, so our circuitry is almost ready. Now we'll label the nodes. So this will label it as G underscore your name. So I'm renaming it as G underscore my name. Similarly, this is the drain terminal and this is the source terminal. Now I'll rename it as D, capital D underscore my name. Similarly, you all can also do that. And this is S, capital S underscore my name. Okay, so your circuit is ready. Only thing is we have to define this IDSS and VP. Now in LTSpice we have to define it indirectly. So let me just write it over here. How to define the JFET parameters. So I'll add the text. Okay. So here the first JFET parameter is JFET parameters. Okay. So the first JFET parameters given are VP is equal to minus 4 volts and IDSS is equal to 10 milliamperes. Okay, now over here in LTSpice dot model statement, when we define these parameters, the IDSS value is defined indirectly. So there is a term called as beta. We have to define its formula is given by IDSS divided by VP square. So if you have a calculator, that is 10 milliamperes actually. So if you do 10 milliamperes divided by 4 square, that will be 10 divided by 16. You will get a value 0.625 into 10 raised to minus 3. So you write E raised E minus 3. So that is equivalent to 10 raised to minus 3. So I'll give it as around 2. I can place these parameters over here. Okay, now how to define a dot model statement? For defining the dot model statement, right click over here. You can go to draft and there is a spice directive over here. Click on it. Here you have to write dot model NJF1 space NJF, that is a reserve keyword. And instead of writing VP, here you write it as VTO. So VP is given by -4. So here you can write VTO equal to -4 volts. And we have write the value of beta. So beta came out to be 0.625E-3. So that is equivalent of saying that we have IDSS equal to 10. That is indirectly we are defining it, as you can see over here. Okay, and click on OK. And you can place it onto the schematic like this. So this NJF, we have to change it to NJF1 so that these model parameters it will take. So once I click on OK, so that means my JFET will take a VP value of -4 and IDSS value of 10 milliamperes. So that's how we have to define it. And also we can do the naming of the circuit. So this will be, we can do it later. First we'll simulate its, let me just close this. Yeah. So first we'll simulate the circuit and check out with the parameters which we have got over here in the table. So let us go back to the table. Yeah, this is the table now. And now I'll simulate, click go to run and go to DC operating point because I want to check the, you know, the DC values of the current and the voltages and click on OK. Okay, so the moment I click on OK, I got the values. So these are the values which I'm getting. Let us compare it with the table. So your ID value is coming out to be 1.8858. So we are getting very close, calculated this 1.8859 and we are getting 1.8858 milliamperes. Now the simulated value of VGS. So VGS will be this VG, which you can see very, very small value. VG is very small, almost equal to zero. So that is 1.46 × 10⁻⁵. That is very close to zero. So VGS will be VG minus VS. So 0 minus 2.26298. So we got it theoretically as calculated value as 2.2629. And here also we are getting 2.2629. So you can see the how close they are. And VDSQ will be VD minus VS. So that will be 12.3426 minus 2.26298. So we are getting a simulated value of 10.0797. So that is very close to the calculated value, 10.0792. So these are the values which we are getting. And whenever you take the schematic, the print screen, what you need to do is you click on run. And the screen which you get, you can place it aside like this. You know, like this. And you can expand it. And this print screen values, you can take it. Okay, along with the circuit. Fine. So one print screen you take of just the circuit. Another print screen, the results as well as the circuit. Okay, let me just shift this. Okay, now I can, last thing is I can rename the circuit as JFET. Self. Bias circuit. Okay, so I can place it at the top. Maybe I can increase a little bit of font. Okay, so this is my JFET cell bias circuit, and that's how we can define the model parameters. They are very, very important. You have to define it this way only, and once you simulate it, you will get the desired results like this. So these are the results which I'm getting by analytical technique, and they are quite matching with the theoretical values. And ID and IS were values were same, as you can see over here. Okay, so now let us go back to the PDF. So this was analytical method of solving the problem and getting the values of IDQ, VGSQ and VDSQ, which were quite matching. The other method is the graphical approach. So graphical approach says that to plot the transfer curve, we have to use this equation and use this four values of ID for different values of VGS. If you work it out, if you put ID as IDSS, you will get VGS as zero. And if you put IDSS by two, you will get VGS is equal to 0.3 times VP. Similarly, if you substitute ID as IDSS by four, you will get VGS as 0.5 VP, and if you substitute ID as 0, we'll get VGS as VP. Okay, so you can work it out. IDS is given as 10 milliampere, so you can get the alternate table. VP is also given as minus 4. So for VGS equal to 0, you get ID as 10 milliampere. For VGS equal to minus 1.2 volt, you get 5 milliampere ID. For VGS equal to minus 2, you get ID equal to 2.5 milliampere. And for VGS equal to minus 4, you get 0 milliampere. Now, this 4 points, you can easily plot the transfer curve. So this orange color curve, we can plot it on a graph paper. So on the y-axis, you have ID in milliamperes. So you can mark it from 0 to 10 milliamperes. And you can, on the x-axis, we have 0 to minus 4 VGS value. So with these 4 points, above points which I have shown, so you can mark it over here. Because it's not a straight line, it's a curve. So with the help of these 4 points, we can easily plot it. Plot the orange color transfer curve over here. Okay, now once we plot this transfer curve, secondly we have to plot the DC load line. So from the circuit, the VG value was 0, the VS value was ID into RS, so VGS was equal to minus ID RS. This is the equation of the load line. So in this equation, we'll substitute ID equal to 0, so VGS will be 0. So that is our first point, 0, 0. In the second case, we put ID equal to IDSS by 4, so that means it is 2.5 milliampere. So VGS will be minus ID into RS. ID is 2.5 milliampere and RS is 1200 ohms. So that if you come out to be minus 3 volts. So second point will be minus 3, 2.5 milliampere. So that we mark it over here. So second point will be minus 3, 2.5 milliampere. Okay, so once we have this second point and the first point is 0.0. And the second point is minus 3, 2.5 milliamperes. We can draw a line. There is a green color line. That is a DC load line. And whenever this DC load line intersects this orange color transfer curve, we will have a Q point. So this is a Q point. If you draw it accurately on the graph paper, you will get VGSQ close to minus 2.25 volts and IDQ close to 1.85 milliamperes. So the intersection of the transfer curve with the DC load line will give my Q point value. So this is how we can graphically determine the Q point as we have shown over here. Okay. So in this audit course lab number 16, you don't have to do it with graphical approach. Just this, just the analytical approach will do. So up here, as soon as you get this table, I think that's it for this lab then. Okay, this is just for additional information which I'm giving you all. So we can determine this entire, all the, values, the Q point values with this approach also. Okay, so these are the values which you are getting by interfacing the transfer curve with the DC load line. Okay, now there is one more kind of load line over here that is in the output characteristics. So here is my DC load line and here is my output characteristics. And whenever my output characteristics interface with the DC load line, I will again get the Q point. Now the Q point is VDSQ, IDQ. So you have to please note that point. Okay. So the Q point is obtained by the intersection of the output characteristics and the DC load line. Previously, we have interfaced the Q point, we got it by interfacing the transfer curve with the DC load line. Okay. So there are two load lines. One is with the output characteristics and one is with the transfer characteristics. So find the coordinates of the DC load line. So we'll rewrite the expression of VDS. So VDS will be VDD minus IDQ into RD plus RS. So we can rearrange it in terms of ID. So ID will be VDD upon RD plus RS minus VDS upon RD plus RS. So if we rearrange it properly, you will get ID is equal to minus 1 upon RD plus RS into VDS plus VDD upon RD plus RS. So this is in familiar form, that is Y equal to MX plus C, where Y is ID, X is VDS, M is the slope is minus 1 upon RD plus RS, and the Y intercept is C is VDD upon RD plus RS. So this is the equation of the DC load line, this equation of the DC load line. Okay. So the coordinates of the intersection will be, we can find out over here. Again, we substitute, we can rewrite the expression VDS equal to VDD minus ID into RD plus RS. So we'll substitute first ID equal to 0. So VDS will be equal to VDD. So the first point will be VDD, 0, that is 18, 0. For the second scenario, we'll put VDS equal to 0 in this equation. If you put VDS equal to 0, ID will be VDD upon RD plus RS. So if you work out in a calculator, you will get ID as 4.2857 milliampere. This is ID basically, not IC. So the second point will be 0.4257 milliampere. So we have these two coordinates. We have these two points now, 18,0 and 0.4285 milliampere. So we, with these two points, we can plot a line. So this is straight line actually. And whenever this DC load line intersects with output characteristics, we'll get a Q point. So we have worked out analytically. The Q point was coming out to be 1.8859 milliamperes, and VDS was coming out to be 10.07 volts. So if we can plot it over here, the Q point will be fairly in the middle. It's not exactly in the middle, but it will be lying on the DC load line. Okay, so this is how we can plot the Q point on the DC load line with an alternate method. So this is also again a different DC point. Okay, so now I think that's it. We have completed our today's objective of analyzing the self bias JFET circuit. So first, by analytical method, we have found out the values of the IDQ and VGSQ, and also the VDSQ. And then by graphical approach, we have determined the Q point, and also by in the output characteristics also, we have plotted the Q point value with the help of DC load line. Okay, so I think that's it for this lab. So you have to complete this lab and find out the values of IDQ, VGSQ and VDSQ in LTSpice. Okay, so that's it for this lab. Thank you for joining. Next time we'll study MOSFET biasing circuit. So until then, have a good day and thank you.